And welcome back. And I'm very glad to say I'm with Vree now, who you've just heard. They are Patrick Rhymes, Jordan Price, and Anne Erin. Thank you very much, Anne Erin Jones. You can't get much more of a Welsh name than that, really, can you? Gentlemen, that was absolutely magnificent. It was absolutely beautiful music. Thank you so much for that, and thanks for joining me. You sort of explained that it's a bit of a conflict between the traditions of the wild Celtic pagan dragons and the stern discipline of the chapel. And you're in, how do you resolve that?
I think, you know, we sort of... Do you mind not to continue after that?
Yeah,
In English.
Yeah.
The nonconformists were king. So they sucked in some traditional music and they mostly turned it into hymn singing. And what... traditional music provided before the nonconformist movement, hymn singing provided afterwards. So the idea is to reclaim that in a way. It's the same spirit, I think. Like, religion and chapels created a very close sense of community in Wales for a very long time. And it's trying to bring that sense of community with music, community music, communal music, just without... God and the rules.
Well, it's funny you should say that, because a few days ago we had from pub to pulpit, which is the wrong direction as far as I'm concerned, talking about Vaughan Williams. Vaughan Williams stealing folk tunes, as it were. Stealing's a strong word. Plagiarising will do. Yeah. Plagiarising folk tunes from pubs and then setting them as hymn tunes. Who won then in this battle? Who's winning now? Because Methodism, or just religion, is on the decline all over Britain anyway. Yeah. So how's it going?
Well, certainly, yeah, Methodism had a pretty strong innings for a couple of years, but it feels like we're sort of...
A couple of centuries.
Well, yeah. And we're sort of wrestling back a little bit of control now. And, it feels like certainly in Wales there is a big revival of traditional art forms, you know, dance music, and that people are becoming a lot more awakened to this sort of rich tradition that we do have. You know, we just have to go digging for it. We've often looked fairly enviously over the border and, you know, up to Scotland and Ireland at these really rich dance music traditions, and sort of, you know, and that it's great that we're discovering our own repertoire. And
You say we're winning there. That you lose all objectivity in that battle when you declare which side you're on there. You're on the side of the dragon rather than the book, aren't you?
I think so, yeah. Sorry. Yeah. sorry, Grandma. Yeah.
Well, one chapel, on average, closes a week in Wales. And most of them now, I mean, they're fabulous buildings. Some have been turned into homes and others being turned into community centres. So it does definitely seems like that's not the... sort of the enemy anymore, yeah. So to speak. Not that it was an enemy as such, but for traditional music, they kind of were.
Well, church music's always been a great influence and very beautiful. If you can synthesise it with something a bit wilder, how wonderful is you just proved. Wales isn't that big, and yet somehow it doesn't feel like one nation. You're from all over the Principality. North Wales is all mountains and diagonal mostly, and South Wales is industrial or post-industrial and not so agricultural. How do you put those two cultures together?
I think I would say that there is differences. Like, there's differences in the way Patrick would speak Welsh and the way I would speak Welsh. Like, there's lots of colloquial... I mean, I sort of didn't understand him for the first 2 years. But I think there's lots of things that can unite North and South, and that is the language itself. Yeah. Because, you know, for instance, in Scotland, you've got, you know, sort of Gaelic on one side of it and, like, Doric and Scots. There's quite a mixture of language where I feel we're quite lucky that we've got this one thing that unifies...
In England, we can hardly understand each other.
Yeah. I think that's the thing. The Welsh language is what unites us, really, because that is whether you speak it or not, that is the one thing that...
That's the literary tradition.
Yeah.
May I'm going to have to stop you, gents, because we've got to go next door for some pipes, I'm afraid. Do forgive me, but thank you so much. What's thank you in Welsh?
Diolch yn fawr.
Diolch yn fawr. Thank you, chaps.